the Chandrayaan 1 was planned, and this is an Indian mission with very significant international participation, and it was indeed it set an example of how space missions could be carried out with the collaboration of a large number of countries. We had about 5 payloads from India and 6 payloads from abroad. You can see here TMC, terrain mapping camera, hyperspectral imager, lunar laser ranging instrument, then high energy X-ray spectrometer, moon impact probe were all built by India. Whereas the Chandrayaan X-ray spectrometer, ESA and ISRO worked together for that. Then we had the near infrared spectrometer by ESA. Then sub-KEV reflecting analyzer, ESA and ISRO, radon instrument, MINISAR and MQ, which were NASA instruments. So this was the launch itself, happened in 22nd October 2008. And the public access to this long time archival data for these payloads is available through Indian Space Science Data Center website since 2013. In fact, this data has been extensively used by a large number of researchers, and we also see many of the publications coming out of data from this particular mission. And Chandrayaan 1 also made a major discovery. It was this mission which is credited with discovery of water molecules on the lunar surface, lunar exosphere. Though a large number of missions have been done to Moon, it is Chandrayaan 1 which demonstrated that water and water molecules are present on the surface of Moon. Water molecules in the lunar exosphere and subsurface water ice deposits in the base of the craters of permanent sun shadow regions. Presence of large expanses of crystalline feldspar on the lunar surface. Reflection of solar wind protons. Then three-dimensional conceptualization of many craters of interest. Water molecules itself, the solar wind interaction. In fact, it also changed the perception of many processes that were taking place on the Moon. Based on the earlier data, it was felt that Moon is bone dry. But then, based on the information that was gathered during this mission, the total scenario change. The hydroxyl and the OH molecules, their expected signature of absorption in the infrared. Of course, the primary instrument for this, MQ, was designed by NASA JPL. And the MINISAR, which was again a synthetic aperture radar of a very small size. And using these two, significant amount of information extraction happened. This particular image you would have probably seen many times. This shows the blue in this shows the 3 micron absorption associated with the presence of OH and H2O. Red regions show the 2 micron region and iron bearing minerals information, and also the reflected brightness in the 2.4 micron region. We also carried a moon impact probe, which did show on the 14th of November when the moon impact probe landed on the surface of Moon. On its journey, it did pick up the water molecules, and of course, initially, because it was not certain at that point of time whether you could believe the data, the first discovery went to MQ and MINISAR and not to this CHASE instrument which was there on the Moon. But of course, subsequently it corroborated the information that was picked up. And synthetic aperture radar again was used, and this ensured, this is an S-band synthetic aperture radar which mapped the polar terrain, and using this they could establish that presence of water ice in the craters. And this shows, of course, because of the premature completion of the mission, there are certain gaps in the total data sets, but otherwise whatever data was picked up was good enough to demonstrate many of the aspects. MINISAR data here shows the ice is heterogeneously distributed, and This is the lunar laser ranging instrument which was built by LIOS, and this shows again the surface, the heights at the different places, and the dark blue region here shows the South Pole Aitken region. Then we had the endogenic water. The study of M3 spectra revealed enhanced signature of OH and water in the Compton-Belkovich volcanic complex, and it also found evidence of hydrated magma indicating episodic and explosive magmatic events. Now these results have changed the earlier concept that prevailed before Chandrayaan 1, when Moon, based on the study of Apollo rocks, was considered to be bone dry and dormant. This again, the image what you are seeing is from the terrain mapping camera and the LRO data. And using this, evidences of volcanic vent and lava pond were found. Then we also had the hyperspectral imager, which shows the giant impact hypothesis and the hot formation of Moon, magma ocean concepts were all got significant impetus using this data. Then another important development was on the results of SARA, a new dimension of solar wind surface interaction. It was believed earlier that all this solar wind is not getting reflected from the Moon surface, but these observations change those concepts. Similarly, the calcium and iron and also the aluminium and potassium, these signatures were found in the KIPPS data. Then this is another interesting development where, for example, you can see a buried rille region, which is actually uncollapsed portion of a lava tube, which is possible that you could have human shelter in this particular region. And recently LRO also confirmed that this region is an uncollapsed portion of a lava tube. Then we have a large number of topographic three-dimensional anaglyph images generated on that. These are just some of the images obtained from Chandrayaan. Now the new perception about the Moon was before Chandrayaan 1 and after Chandrayaan 1, if you see, initially it was said Moon is dry, then it became an active hydrosphere, presence of OH and water molecules in the lunar surface, lunar environment. It was considered to be geologically dead billions of years back, but there is significant amount of data which shows it is dynamic and volcanically active. You also have a complete absorption of the impinging solar wind protons by the lunar regolith. Now it is believed that about 20% of the solar wind protons are reflected from the lunar surface. Then there was no evidence of magma ocean earlier. Now it is validated that global magma ocean hypothesis is valid. Lunar surface is vulnerable to impacts of meteorites or other bodies as well as energetic particles. Now detection of potential site buried lava tubes for future human habitability on the Moon.